Hi, I'm Jim, W6LG. Welcome to my radio room and Ham Radio Basics. And today we're going to talk about something I've wanted to do for a long time, and that's coax cable. Probably nothing's more basic to a ham radio station than the cable that's used. So I've gotten the two most common sizes, RG8X, sometimes called Mini 8 back in the old days, and RG213. You know, they're both sets of cables are made in the U.S., in the Midwest, and know the manufacturer, so I know they're good cables. On the RG213, a couple of the connections I've made myself, which is going to be another episode. I'm going to show you an easy way to put on a coax connector. Really, it's not all that hard, and we can do it in maybe a minute and be done with it and be assured that it's a good connection. But anyway, well, I'm getting ahead of where I want to be, as usual. On a table to my right, I have the two bird watt meters that I had in a prior episode, 100-foot length of RG8X, which has some connectors in it, so it's not a continuous length. I figured that would be better because the typical ham radio station isn't going to have exactly 100 feet with no connections. There are going to be connections, so there's like four. Same thing with the RG213. It's broken up into some pieces, and again, I measured them on a counter I have downstairs, so they're right at 100 feet, and I had to kind of add and subtract other pieces of coax to get it right to 100 feet, but they're right on. So I'm going to transmit 100 watts with one of the K3s into bird number one through the coax, bird number two, and then into the dummy load. And we'll measure the loss, so we'll see 100 watts in here, and what will number two show? And I don't know. My recollection is that RG8X is a lot lossier than RG213, but I'm not sure. So we're going to do this test in just a minute. One of the things that I thought I might show you is that. That is what I used as a dummy load as a kid, and I made one recently. There's a little bit of a trick to doing this thing, but it allows you to see RF. Because we're going to convert it to, light. So that's roughly 100 watts going into the light bulb, and you can see I'm using SSB. If I were on CW, of course, it would be different, or FM, for example. So there's going to be a break in the video. I'm going to disconnect that, hook it up, and we'll do the test and see what we come up with. And one of the other tests that we're going to do in the future is to line up a couple of transceivers, and in particular stuff that I already have. So I'm going to take the K3 and a Yaesu 857, which is the same thing as an 897, and compare the receivers in the real world. So, I mean, on the air, we're going to tune in some weak stations, probably from Europe, when the band is open, and do like an A-B test. And is there a big difference between the 857, which retails, or they're used, I guess, because they're not in production anymore, but they're worth maybe, I don't know, $500, $600, $700, something like that, against a $4,000 transceiver. And is there a difference? Is there $3,000 worth of difference? There may not be. My thought is there'd probably be a difference in selectivity. So that's one of the things I've got lined up for the future, in a future episode on Ham Radio Basics, is the sort of all-in-one transceivers. I've also got an ICOM IC7000 and some others. How do they compare to a top-flight rig, the one that's currently being used on some de-expeditions? Or is the ICOM IC7000 as good? They do a lot of neat things. They have a lot of features in them. And the newer Yaesus are just amazing. I'm shocked as to what they can do with it. Anyway, I've got to hurry this along. I want to keep the video short. So we're going to go do the tests. And again, I'm going to transmit with 100 watts. We're going to take a break, set it up, because I'm going to have to move a camera and shoot some video of the bird watt meters. So here we go. What happens when you use 100 watts into coax, and I'm going to do it on 10 meters this time, on 10 meters, what do you think the loss will be? Will I lose 5 watts, 10 watts, 15 watts, 30 watts? Jeez, 40 watts? I don't know. It could be, maybe not. So let's find out how much power are you delivering to your antenna and how many microvolts of signal are coming down the coax and how much is being lost. So here we go. Stand by. W6LG back in a minute. Okay, I'm back. Got some glasses so I can read the meter. And here we go. I don't know what's going to happen. First coax I'm going to test is RG213, precisely 100 feet. I've taken the K3 to 10 meters, put it into FM mode. I'm going to run 100 watts with the K3. K3 will do 110 watts, so I can, I've got room to maneuver around 100 watts. Going to look at meter number one, dial up 100 watts, and then read number two with my glasses on. So here we go. Put it in transmit, actually into tune. Okay, that's exactly 100 watts, and I'm doing the RG213. About 82 watts. Okay, so it's 82% efficient. Not as much as I thought. Okay, so, all right, so if you're running 100 watts, you may be putting about 80, 82 watts to the antenna. Let's try the RG8X next and see what it ends up doing. So, be another jump cut. Back in a second. Okay, I'm back. Let's do the RG8X and see what happens. So, I'm going to dial up 100 watts again. Should be the same. Oop. There we go. And let's see what it reads. Again, I've got glasses. Can't see without it. Okay, that's exactly 100 watts, and that is 70. Precisely 70. Well, that's a surprise. So that's 70, and I mean, it's dead nuts on 70. So, I'm surprised. So, I'm surprised by the amount. It's a significant loss. So that's 70 watts, 70% for the RG8X and 82% for the RG213. I thought the difference would be bigger, a lot bigger than that. And so it's, by the way, the age of the coax, it's not new coax. I didn't pull new stock. I got some coax that I had downstairs that was in a box where I keep miscellaneous pieces. It's not bad coax. It's maybe 5 years old. Hasn't been outside. It's been used in here for various projects. So there we go. What's the difference between RG8X and RG213? About 12% at 100 feet. Is that significant? Maybe not. Now, the difference on 2 meters is going to be much, much bigger, but I'm not set up to do that. And I'm basically an HF guy. I'm not a 2 meter 440 kind of guy. I'm stumped for words because it's not what I thought it was going to be. So, RG213 is really good coax. It's non-contaminating. It's American made. All the connectors are good. Tell you what, I'm going to take another break. I'm going to go online, grab a calculator online that will show me the loss for the two kinds of coax at a certain frequency and length. And let's just see what that says. So we'll, and that would be for new coax. I think Times Microwave, one of those, has a calculator on their website. So, well, who knew? Back in a few, W6LG, stand by for news. Okay, hi, welcome back, and I set up on one of my screens a calculator for measuring the loss from Times Microwave. You put in the frequency and the length of the coax and the type of coax, and it gives you the loss for new coax. So according to it, on 30 megahertz, 100-foot length, powered 100 watts, Power getting, it says power getting to the antenna, 77 watts. I measured 82, so that's pretty close. Okay, doing RG8X, and sorry I had to turn around to do it, but I have a notepad, but the battery was dead, of course, when I wanted to use it. So it says 68%. We measured less than that, actually more than that. So it's pretty much in line with what you would get if you use a calculator. So as I want to end this, because I don't want to make this a super long video, what does all this mean? I guess it means that if you're running 100 watts to an antenna, you want to keep the coax as reasonably short as you can. As we learned from, I think, one of the first videos I made, the number of coax connectors doesn't seem to matter much. And I'm going to do that test again. Some people have written and asked, and I'll do it on 10 meters next. What is significant is the loss in the coax. So if you've got 100 feet of coax and you're losing 30 watts, that's a significant loss. Anyway, I learned a lot doing this test. I hope you did too. Okay, that ended kind of abruptly, but the power blinked and this is why it's snowing. If you liked the video, please check like. And if you want to subscribe, great. I've got some more things planned. 7-3 from Jim, W6LG for Ham Radio Basics.